Hello my friends! Today we are gonna talk about how to use the most important VS Code shortcuts to increase our productivity. If you are a beginner, using a mouse and regular shortcuts are okay, but if you want to be more professional, you must learn how to use your keyboard efficiently. But don't worry, after this video, you are gonna be much faster. If you are ready, let's get started. Firstly, when you open your projects, most probably you are clicking here and searching for your folders. Not this one. It's gonna be hotel app, but if you have a lot of folders here, it can be a waste of time. So what I'm gonna do is opening my terminal. By the way, you can do this using Ctrl and tilde buttons and writing here code and my application name, which is hotel app. I will enter and that's all, it's here. If it's in the another folder, I'm gonna go to desktop and my project name. It's that easy. By the way guys, during this video you'll probably think that using a mouse is easier and faster. Well, for a couple of weeks after starting using these shortcuts, you are right, it's gonna be hard for you, but once you get used to it, you will see how fast you are and you will regret that you didn't use them before. Okay, let's go on. After opening your project, you will probably use different files at the same time, like here, index, style and JavaScript file. Let's say I'm writing some code here. I will say div and class name will be my div and I wanna give some style for this div. Instead of clicking here, writing my style and coming back, creating another one and going back again. So basically, instead of doing this with mouse, I can use my keyboard and I can use tab numbers. It's gonna be number 1, 2 and 3. I can use alt button and if I press on 1, as you can see, it's in the index file. Alt and 2, style, Alt and 3, JavaScript file. It's gonna work like that. So if I create here another div, I can quickly go to style CSS and write other divs. But imagine that we have many files here. We are working with multiple pages or multiple CSS files or JavaScript files. I cannot count them like that. So what I'm gonna do is using Ctrl and P button and writing here some letters of my target file. As you can see, I can go to contact.html quickly, Ctrl P. I want to go to app.js or style CSS. It's that easy. You might say selecting here is easier, but imagine you have many pages, folders, files, and instead of searching for them in the sidebar, just use Ctrl P and search for it. And after working a while, you will probably have many tabs here. To prevent this, after finishing your task, you can close them using Ctrl and W, like that. In this case, it's gonna close them one by one. And if you want to close all tabs here, you can use Ctrl, K and W, like that. It's gonna close everything. By the way, if you are creating here a folder, let's say folder and inside another folder and inside this maybe my file. Instead of doing this, let's delete here. I can come here and say folder slash folder 2 slash my app.js. In this case, it's gonna create those folders and inside this file. So you don't have to waste your time. So if you want to see more coding area, you can close your sidebar using Ctrl and B and you can open it again like that. And you can zoom in or zoom out using Ctrl minus or Ctrl plus, like that. And let's say you have a lot of HTML elements here and it's not possible to remember every class name here. Instead of going style CSS again and again, you can basically split your editor using Ctrl and backslash. In this case, to switch between different slices, you can use control and slice number. It's gonna be our slice number 1, slice number 2. So if I say control 1, we are here. Control 2, we are here. So if I come here and close this tab using control and W, right now I can see my class names and I can give some styles for them. By the way guys, we are gonna talk about a lot of shortcuts. As I said at the beginning, it's gonna be hard to memorize all those things, but I promise you, after coding, let's say 1 month, you will not even recognize you are using them. You are gonna be like a robot. Okay, let's say you want to install a library, or basically you want to push your project to GitHub. So what you can do is opening terminal, control and tilde. When writing any command here, if you have any mistake, let's say git and init, as you can see there's a typo here, it's gonna give me this error. Instead of writing this again, you can just use your arrow keys and it's gonna repeat the previous command, and you can come here and fix it. If you want to clear your terminal, you can write here, just clear and enter. Okay, let's see how we can be faster while coding. I'm gonna delay it here and I'm gonna write something between this div. I will say hello Lama Dev. So imagine my cursor is here and I'm gonna change this hello Lama Dev text. So instead of going there one by one like that, I can use control and arrow buttons and it's gonna skip all blocks like that quickly. Let's say I want to select this text like that. Instead of using mouse, I can use shift button and my arrow buttons like that. I'm using shift and left button, as you can see, but it's going one by one again. Remember, we can skip blocks like that, so I can combine them. I'm gonna use shift and control and my arrow buttons like that. And I can delete here or whatever I want. It's that easy. Let's go to meta tag, for example, and I want to delete all meta tags here. So I'm gonna use shift down arrow. I'm not gonna take this title, so I will go back like that and I'm just gonna delete. That's all. And also, what else you can do? You can delete lines one by one. To do that, I'm gonna use control and X. As you can see, I'm in this line right now. I'm using control X and it's gone. Control X, it's gone. I can do the same thing for copying the line. I will use control C and if I paste it, control V. As you can see, I can copy and paste lines like that without selecting any elements. Okay, let's delete here. And also you can comment out your lines. I'm on this line right now. I will say control and slash, as you can see, commented out. To open this again, control slash and it's here. And also you can use it for multiple lines. I'm gonna select here, remember shift and arrow, and I will use control slash like that and open again. As I said, you can copy and paste lines using control C and control V. But there is a more efficient way and I'm using that all the time. What I'm gonna do is using alt, shift and down arrow like that. As you can see, it duplicates the line. Let's say we created this list here and I want to add more list items. So what I'm gonna do is selecting this li and alt, shift and down arrow like that. I can duplicate it like that. Okay, I created my items, but let's say I realize that these images are not gonna be PNG, they are gonna be GIF. So instead of selecting them and changing one by one, I can use replace shortcut, which is control and H. And I can search for .png and it's gonna find all those images and I'm gonna change with GIF. If I enter, it's gonna change only this one. If I enter again, it's gonna change this one also. Basically, to replace one by one, we can use enter to replace all those images, we can use Ctrl, Alt and Enter. I will do that. And as you can see, all those PNG files are GIF right now. But it might be dangerous. Let's say we have another image here, image.png. If you do that, you are gonna change this extension also. So I'm gonna recommend another shortcut. I will choose what I want to change. It's gonna be .gif, and I will use Ctrl and D. As you can see, it has chosen this one also. If I do this again, Ctrl D, it's gonna choose this one. Like that. And right now it's easy to change. Let's say PNG again. Oops. PNG. Why it's that important? Because you have the control right now. Let's say you have another image here. Another PNG, but you want to change only those list items images. So we are not gonna touch here, or we are not gonna touch here. So basically, I can choose my initial point, it's gonna be here. So when I press on Ctrl and D, it's gonna start from this line. It's not gonna affect here. It's gonna choose always the next one, like that. And what else? If you want to write same thing in multiple lines, basically you can use Alt button and left click. Let's say I'm gonna add something here. I'm clicking and I'm holding Alt button and clicking here. And Alt button clicking here. As you can see, we can write same thing for these lines. Let's add title, for example. H1, this is title. That's all. And again, you can choose this title, Ctrl D, and delete. If you want to move your lines or blocks, you can hold the Alt button. Let's say we are in this line. I'm gonna hold Alt button and I'm gonna move it using arrow buttons, like that. I'm holding Alt button, up arrow, down arrow. It works like that. And it's really useful. Let's open our app.js. And as you can see, we have an array here and a function, but there is something wrong here, that because by mistake, I wrote this else block inside if block. So what I'm gonna do is selecting this else block, remember shift and arrow, and I'm gonna move it using Alt and down arrow, like that. That's all. So you can move your lines or blocks using Alt and arrow button. It's that easy. So imagine you have hundreds of lines, many functions, variables. So instead of scrolling and trying to find them, you can use Ctrl, Shift and O. And as you can see, all your variables and all your functions are here. So for this function, I'm gonna click and it's here. And again, I'm gonna go to user and that's all. So you can find them like that. When we run our application, we always see these kinds of errors in the browser or in the console. But now we know where the error is, as you can see, line number 11. And again, instead of scrolling to that line, we can use Ctrl and G. And if I write here 11, as you can see, it's going that line and I can fix my problem. And another useful thing, when you read codes, it can be from another people or it can be your old codes. So basically, it might be confusing to understand or remember where all those functions or variables come from and what they include. So only thing you should do is hover over that function, for example. If I press on Ctrl button, as you can see, I can see what it includes. For this list, for example, this here, this user, when I hover over, it just says object and types, but press on Ctrl and come again. As you can see, John and 23. And also, I can click on them while pressing Ctrl button, and it's gonna show us the exact line. Let's come here and choose this list. I will click and we are here. Perfect. And we can also use it for images or any links. I will hold Ctrl button and click, as you can see, it opens that URL. And one of the most important thing is using snippets for your favorite language or any frameworks. It allows you to use specific shortcuts. For example, I'm using JavaScript, React, or styled components. In this case, I'm able to use some specific commands or any other shortcuts. So if you are using any framework, I highly recommend you to use those extensions. It's gonna make you much faster. And if you want to know my favorite VS Code extensions, you can watch that video in the cards. And before ending this video, I'm gonna recommend one more thing. And it's touch typing. It basically means using keyboard without looking at it. So you should always look at the screen and type your codes like that. It's gonna make you super productive. I know it's really hard for some of you, but you just need some practice. There are tons of websites and applications to improve your typing skills. And another important thing is, of course, the keyboard. You should find your favorite type of keyboard and practice. If you ask my opinion, I always prefer mechanical keyboards, but in my YouTube tutorials, I'm using laptop keyboards because the mechanical one is too loud and I don't want to annoy you. Imagine you are watching 2 hours tutorial with that sound. It can be really annoying. So I'm not comfortable using laptop keyboards. I make a lot of mistakes, typos, and you probably noticed that. But some of people are totally opposite. They really love thin keyboards like magic keyboard or laptop keyboards. So basically it depends on you. Just find a decent keyboard and practice. Okay, that's all. If you learned something new today, please like the video. And if you want to support Lama Dev, you can join the channel or you can use the link in the description below. And don't forget to follow Lama Dev's social media accounts. I hope I'll see you in the next tutorial. Goodbye.